Khan Academy Hyderabad, and I've developed this movie as a school project on how plants reproduce. Plants reproduce in two ways, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Let's see how plants reproduce asexually. Asexual reproduction occurs when a new individual is born from a single parent.
Potato is an excellent example of a tuber.
This is a potato. You can see that buds are coming out of it. It is an underground stem. This is the way how it reproduces.
And after some time, leaves come out. And as the leaves shut, and you can see a mature garlic in the soil like this.
For this project, I've even visited Raj Nursery. It is in Yatmal. So when I entered here, it was full of beautiful flowers, which you can see here. Here are almost all the flowers which I need for my project.
For this project, I've met Mr. Heather. He's owner of this nursery. Mr. Heather, how do you know so much about plants?
I have completed my BSc in botany. That is why I have knowledge about the plant and their reproduction and their altogether morphology and difference, their growth, etc.
This is an example of Farana. It grows horizontally, and when they touch the ground, they become a new independent plant. This is a fern plant. After completing its vegetative growth, the spores come on it and it looks like this. Then the spores fall on the ground with water and forms a new fern plant.
This is one of the examples of a plant which grows from its leaf. This plant reproduces sexually. You can see a baby plant growing from here.
This is a rose plant. It grows from its stem. If we want a new rose plant, we have to cut the stem and plant wherever we want. So, after that, you will get a new rose plant.
This is a sugarcane plant. It reproduces through its stem.
This is a plant which is developed by grafting technique. Grafting is a technique where tissues from one plant are inserted in another one. So, here you can see that the first plant is inserted into the another one.
This is a plant which is developed by the budding technique. A small bud is removed from a parent plant and the base of it is inserted in the bark of the stem. This is called budding.
This is a gerbera plant, which is most commonly developed by tissue culture.
This is hibiscus flower. This is stamen, which consists of anther and filament. This is carpel, which consists of stigma, style, and ovary.
The pollen grains transfer from here to the stigma, and then it forms, it goes to the ovary, and ovary forms fruit, and ovule forms seed.
For sexual reproduction to happen, male sex cells have to reach female sex cells. This process is called pollination. When animals such as bees, butterflies, pollinate plants, it's accidental. They are not trying to pollinate the plant. Usually, they are at the plant to get food. The sticky pollen or the sweet nectar made at the base of the petals when feeding the animals accidentally rub against the stamens and get pollen stuck all over themselves. When they move to another flower to feed, some of the pollen can rub off onto a new plant stigma.
This is a pomegranate plant. After pollination, the petals fall down and then ovary becomes fruit and ovule becomes
the seeds of a plant are scattered over large distances. This is called dispersal of seeds. Seeds are dispersed by wind, water, animal, and explosion of fruit. These are called agents of dispersal. We can see that birds and animals are carrying the seeds from one place to another attached to their fur.